In my years of working online, I've often found, like a lot of many other people, that social media is a bit quicksand in that the ground is constantly moving beneath your feet and you never know what's coming next. Yes, everybody should have a presence on social media if you're a professional, but on the other hand, you're not making the rules. They're making the rules, and you've got to follow their rules. And they're always tweaking their algorithms. They're always telling you what's allowed and what's not allowed. And then they're always changing the rules about what's allowed and not allowed. And you could unintentionally fall foul of rules that you didn't know existed. And the number of people who can see your posts are always decreasing and increasing. And people can't see things unless you pay to have them boosted and so on. Despite all the downsides, it's still worth having a Facebook business page. Partly because a lot of people are on Facebook, so there's a certainty that most of your readers are going to be on Facebook. And secondly, you can't run Facebook adverts without a page, without a business page. Now, Facebook adverts is just like SEO. It's a massive topic, and we'll go into it in another video. I might even have to go into two videos. But today we're going to discuss the whole business page situation. Having a page is free, so there's no reason not to have one. But you've got to be realistic about you've got to be realistic about what you will get out of that page. Not everybody is going to see it unless they visit the page, so not everybody who follows your page is going to get all of your posts in their feed. If you pay to have the post boosted, still not everybody's going to see the post. You know, more people will see it, but not everybody. The effectiveness and the reach of a page is very questionable. But on the other hand, as I said, you need a page to be able to run adverts. And it's still good to have the page because you can promote the link, you can send it to your readers, you can say, you know, come to the page, read my updates, you can set up an informal community of your readers. And there are quite a lot of features on the page that make it worthwhile. For example, you can set up a shop on your page. So I have all my books on the Facebook page and they link back to their Amazon listings. So anybody can just click on the link and get taken to Amazon and they'll be able to buy the book. So that's good to have an extra bit of exposure for my products. There's also the messenger aspect if you want to keep in touch with people. I'm personally not too keen with that because obviously I don't want to spend all day chatting to people. I'd rather get on with work and write the next book and so on. But obviously, depending on what business you're in, that's obviously a good thing to be able to have a direct contact with the people who are buying your product. You can get reviews on Facebook, for example. So, you know, people can leave reviews and then, you know, other people can come along and read those reviews, just like Google reviews or like Amazon reviews. It's the same thing on Facebook. So there are quite a lot of things that are on the page that are worth it. But as I said, temper your expectations, okay? It's never going to be a replacement for a proper website. And not everybody who follows you is going to see everything that you post. Not unless you get your wallet out and you start paying. Okay? So to start a page, you just go to facebook.com. Obviously sign in. And then on the menu, on the left-hand side, you will see a link called Pages with a little flag next to it. Click on Pages, and then, let me see, where's the new, yes. Once you're on the Pages page, on the left-hand side, it will say Create New Page. Click that link, follow all the on-screen prompts. Upload your graphics, decide on your page name, your page link, add in all the relevant information that you want people to know, and the page is published. That's it. I will say though that to the best of my knowledge, you also need to have a personal profile on Facebook as well, because I think the personal profile and the Facebook page are connected to one another. I'm pretty certain that you can't start a page without a profile being connected. If I'm wrong on that, please let me know in the comments. I'll re-record this video with the right information, but I'm pretty certain you need a personal profile as well for the two of them to be connected. So, yeah. Make your page, and next time, well, sometime in the near future, I'll start going into Facebook ads. As I said, it's a massive topic, and it's going to take a while to get through all the relevant information. I may even have to do screen sharing for this one to show you all the different screens and what you have to remember. Okay, but I will get on that soon.